Hello, my name is Cal Molinet from Richmond, Virginia, and I'm an anarchist. And today I'm here at VCU once more, away from the construction noise, to spread the message of freedom. And I'd like to make an announcement that, well, this will be in the newsletter coming out this month, coming out tonight, that on the 20th we're going to be doing a analyzing agorism. So it will present the counter-economic arguments and different ways that you can be a participant of the black market, you know, against fiat currency, against the monopoly control of government. And at the same time, we have a Bitcoin workshop on the 14th, 2 p.m. at the Nevermore Anarchy Garden. So we have a lot of events coming out. Check out the calendar on the Liberate RVA website. And with that, hopefully I'll see some of you there. I'll continue doing what I do best. See you guys at the victory party and take good care.
So that's how this organization is immoral. That this organization, government, then only knows how to solve problems the one way, a singular way, and that's through the threat of and use of violence to solve any problems versus the plurality of non-violent solutions that you and I already share. So what are your thoughts on that?
I mean, I guess that is accurate.
Right?
Yeah. I mean, you're not wrong there.
Right.
But I mean, I guess at the same time, I mean, it's kind of necessary what the government has to do, and it's not the most effective method, but...
What is it that government has to do?
Keep us safe and regulate the laws of the land, I guess.
Okay, alright, so we could look at that. So you said keeping us safe, like protecting us, you're saying, like security, you mentioned, right?
Yes.
Did you know that the Supreme Court has ruled in many Supreme Court cases, like Duchesne versus Winnebago, that the police have no obligation, no constitutional duty to protect your life, liberty, or property? None. The only time they do is when you're detained, you know, most likely for a victimless crime. So already, you're paying for a service in which they don't have to provide, right? And if I came to your house with such a contract, would you ever sign such a thing?
No, I wouldn't. No. I wouldn't.
Sometimes we'll provide you internet, sometimes we'll provide you connection, right? Sometimes, when we feel like it, you're like, no, I want a contract, I want a guarantee, I want security, I want obligation, right? Otherwise, I'll go somewhere else, otherwise I'll provide it or compete in the market to provide it, right? So, right there, right then, government then, all they are objectively, they have a monopoly on the services that you and I want. Right, I want roads, I want security, I want law. They have a monopoly on law. They have a monopoly on like USPS, the post office, is a monopoly on delivering pieces of paper. It's illegal and criminal for FedEx, UPS, and DHL to deliver pieces of paper. They can only deliver packages, right? So that's what government is. They have a monopoly in these services in which though you don't have the economic freedom to cancel or unsubscribe as you would from a real business, right? Remember Netflix tried to raise their prices 2 years ago? And people are like, you know what? No, forget that. Cancel, unsubscribe, go into Hulu, right? They have choices, right? When government increases their prices, you don't have a choice. When McDonald's increases their prices, I go to Cookout, right? Or if I want bigger, if I want more value, I go to Five Guys or something, right? But when government does it in taxes, you don't have a choice because they also make it illegal for you to compete entrepreneurially in order to say, I can provide you a better service that's not going to be abusive or harmful to you, the consumer. So you can't even compete in the market. You can't even compete against USPS. You can't compete against the monopoly security. Like in Ferguson right now that they have. So like a lot of people are coming in to try to provide private security, but they're telling them, sorry, you can't be here. You can't do that. You know, there's a lot of people going on the rooftops trying to provide security, but the cops say, no, you have to go home. You can't provide security. We're the ones who can do it. But of course, the result of that is this, the whole place in, as a mess, right? That's disorder, right? That's not real security that they're really being provided there, right?
Yeah.
So that's what you have when you have a monopoly. Anytime you have a government, cost goes up and quality depreciates.
So what is your proposed solution to this problem?
All right, so I want these stuff like you and I want. Like we were talking like government provides. I want these services too, but I want the freedom to choose who can provide it best, right? Or at least I can compete in the market to provide it for you, right? So I want real contracts. Remember, there exists no factual evidence that you can show me a contractual relationship with government. Right, doesn't exist. Yeah. But you can show me a contract with Netflix, AT&T, car payments, apartment complex, you know, when you get a loan contracts, right? But with government, doesn't exist. So the solution would be, the organization I'm with is a non-political organization. So it has nothing to do with politics or government.
What organization is that?
Liberate RVA.
Okay. Yeah.
So it's a non-political organization. Our solution is we want to get to a free society based on consent. Versus that's consensual, that's voluntary. Versus what the government is, which is non-consensual, non-contractual, and coercive, right? A politician can tell you, a stranger you've never met, what you can do with your own life, what you can and cannot do with your own body. But you can't tell that same politician the same thing, right? It's from the top down. Like when you go into the courthouse, it's you have to stand up before the judge, even if you're paying his salary, right? It should be the other way around if I'm the consumer, right? If I'm paying your salary, right?
Yeah.
So it'd be the complete opposite, where the consumer, you are in charge, you're king, right? You're in control now. You're the one where all the ways you can take your business somewhere else who can provide you, a better sense of a welcomeness, right? That's not going to treat you bad, right?
Yeah.
That's not going to be abusive to you, right? But unfortunately, the government, since they have a monopoly, they don't have to improve that. They've outlawed competition, right?
Correct.
Right. So that would be the solution.
Hey man, I like what you're saying. Well, yeah? I have to be going.
Yeah, you gotta go. Yeah, you gotta find us, right?
Yeah. Great talking to you.
Thanks. Me too, man. Yeah. Well, let me give you some pamphlets real quick before you head out.
Of course, of course.
Yeah. I told you.
I would gladly take one.
Yeah, man. Here you go, man.
Thank you.
Yeah, no,
you enlighten me.
You take good care, brother. You have no freedom of economic choice. You still have to give me your money. You still have to give up your property. You still have to pay your taxes. Because if you did have a freedom of economic choice of what to do with your own money, government wouldn't threaten to send you to another cage if you didn't pay your taxes, right? So that's how this organization is immoral. Government, therefore, only knows how to solve problems through one way, a singular way, and that's through the threat of and use of violence to solve any problems, versus the plurality of nonviolent solutions that you and I already share.
Okay.
So what are your thoughts on that?
Well, I'd like to hear some of the, alternatives that you would suggest.
Yeah, all right, absolutely. Okay, so like the alternatives that I guess we advocate for is a free society based on consent. For example, there exists no factual evidence so you could show me a contractual relationship with government, right?
Yeah.
It doesn't exist. But you could show me your contract with Netflix, AT&T, your car payments, real contract, explicit consent, right?
Sure.
So that will be the alternative, one that is contractual, voluntary, consensual, versus one that's coercive, involuntary, non-contractual, right?
That is government. Born into.
Right. It's like Social Security. You never gave consent to it, but you're forced to pay for it. When it's time for you to retire, there'll be nothing left for you, right? So that's all that government is then. Government has a monopoly then on the services you and I want. Because I do want roads, I want law, I want security, I want first class mail. They have a monopoly here with ABC on alcohol, right?
Yeah.
You don't have the freedom, though, to cancel or to subscribe as you would from a real business, right? Nor do you have the freedom to compete entrepreneurially in order to say, I could provide you a better service that's not going to be abusive or harmful to you, the consumer, right? So that's what we advocate for, a free society that's contractual.
Okay.
At least you'll have thousands of competing societies catering to your lifestyle and preference. You can have an apartment complex that's 420 friendly, one across the street that's not, right? But at least with real rules that you give explicit consent to, right? Contractual.
Yeah.
Because that's what government is. They have a monopoly in law, they have a monopoly in these services, and that's all that judges do. Just they've given up what they say fair and impartial opinion and how to resolve disputes. Right?
Yeah.
And you kind of have these already on Etsy, on eBay, your credit card company, right? And you have internal regulations for that too, right? I don't buy anything that has like one star, 1 out of 5 stars, right?
Yeah.
So you have a lot of different ways that we can regulate ourselves in that respect without government or strangers meddling in within our voluntary trade with one another, right?
Okay.
So what do you think of that then?
I don't know. But preventing violence in the world, what would now be classified as criminal activities like homicide, robbery. I mean, you might have to sift through the right services before you found one that was effective.
Yeah,
and if you lived in a really, rural area, then maybe you wouldn't be able to find those services, the best ones.
Well, you will still have those services. I mean, when you have competition, you have a huge tiered level to meet your economic needs, right? 7 billion people in the world, 6 billion of them have cell phones now, right?
Mm-hmm.
Things become really affordable, right? When nearly half your income,
you say 6 billion?
Yeah.
Wow.
When nearly half your income isn't solely through taxes, you have now a lot of money, right? $10 for security, I could throw in $15 for dispute organization to resolve my conflicts, right?
Yeah.
It becomes a lot cheaper when there's competition, right?
Yeah.
Quality goes up, costs go down. I may not afford an iPhone 8, but I can get an iPhone 3 now, right?
Yeah.
Look at Black Friday for all the cheap plasma screen thin TVs now. Several years ago, it was $1,000, right?
Yeah.
You buy a better version for a few $100. When government has a monopoly, though, the opposite happens. Cost goes up. When they ask you, how do you feel about the cost of stamp prices? It's not like I have a choice.
Yeah, right.
And quality depreciates, right? Which is why there's $16 billion in debt, threatening to cut off Saturdays, and their solution to solving long wait lines, because they're not a business, is removing the clocks. So you don't know how long you've been waiting in line, right? So that's the quality. Quality goes down with government because there's no competition. There's no need to improve, right?
So you're saying also, you know, like standardized, like, I don't know what to call it, but for example, you know, like the certificate of like a driver's license, would that also become like part of the free market? You know,
yeah.
Like you'd subscribe to whatever service you wanted that would appraise like how good a driver you were and if that was acceptable.
You know what? You'd never have to wait long lines at DMV. You would never have that.
But what about like infrastructure? Like, I mean, would that retain?
No, that's a really good question. So already right now, how it exists, like the roads, businesses build the roads. Government outsources that to like the politically connected. So you still don't have a choice to choose, right?
Yeah.
So I would like to choose. I'd like to know, hey, I've been in business for 10 years. Look at my customer reviews. You know, potholes, never been potholes, always filled overnight, you know?
Yeah.
We do our construction within these hours, never when the next time of driving.
But then would those services like not own that land? Would that be
they would own it. So businesses would kind of get together and buy these tracts of land because they want to facilitate point A, you at your house, to come into point B, their business stores, right?
Yeah.
Like malls, for example, that is a road when you're walking in there, right?
Right.
They also provide free security on Segways, right? And free Wi-Fi, bathroom services, right? Things that used to cost a lot, now they're, you know, affordable and free that they give away, right?
Yeah.
So they have incentive now to kind of bring you there.
Okay.
So the market will find a way. People build this stuff to begin with, right? It's interesting when people think the word government automatically is, oh, solution solved. Like, no, there's a lot of complications that come with that. You know, they're not a business, so they can't function efficiently. They can't allocate resources efficiently, right? Whereas a business model could, right? Fast overnight. It's like, we need to change this up. We have to do this. The government have to go through entire bureaucracy. The government, they have to go through to panels and other people that have nothing to do with those businesses to begin with, right?
Yeah.
Right. So yeah, that's how you doing? So yeah, so that's how that would be solved, I guess, in terms of providing infrastructure.
Yeah.
Right. At least you wouldn't have there would be no eminent domain, right, where government come and steals their land for, you know, the greater good or whatever unjustifiable reason that they come up.
And it would, I don't know. Yeah, I mean, this system has kind of like given us the mentality that things are beyond our control, I guess.
Yeah.
It'd be nice to discard that.
Yeah, absolutely, absolutely. And then you'll be in charge. You wouldn't have like politicians telling you how best your life should be lived, telling you what you can and cannot do with your own body, right? Strangers that you've never met, right? You won't have that at all, right? You'll have real final respect for private property, for self-ownership. Right, because you have to remember, like, we think of like the police protecting our property, but the Supreme Court has ruled in many cases that they have no constitutional duty or obligation to protect your life, liberty, or property. So for me, that blew me away when I come across that information. Right, so I'm being forced to pay for a service they don't have to provide.
Okay, question then.
Yeah, absolutely.
Why? I mean, because this does seem like a very attractive alternative to, you know, the system of government we have in place. Mm-hmm. You know, catering a lot of these services.
Mm-hmm.
So then, are there examples you can give me of places in the world where it has been?
So the areas in which interactions, relationships are voluntary, consensual, you can find them within our own interpersonal relationships.
Right.
Right. These are freedom of association, disassociation, right? They're voluntary, they're consensual.
Of course,
And that would be a real world example.
No, but I'm talking about one where, like, you know,
they existed in the past or something?
No, like, you know, outside of the United States where, I mean,
I could provide you one, a history, historically. All right, the Wild West was not so wild. Before all those people headed out west, they got together in their companies to have contractual relationships with one another. In the event they got disputes, how they would resolve the problems.
Right.
So they had contracts with one another, like all the cattle ranches, all the people mining for gold, and the highest murder rate of any of these cities that they founded out there was like maybe 2 a year. It wasn't really high, because you wouldn't want to get rid of like, so this is like the entire opposite of like the Hollywood myths that they present. Because if you kill the store clerk, you know, it's like, where are you going to find all the network and connections to bring all these goods in the middle of nowhere?
Yeah.
Right? So they came out there.
It's like in Red Dead Redemption.
Yeah.
You ever played that?
I played that. Yeah.
You kill the kid, you can't buy anything.
Exactly. So people had real fundamental respect for private property and for rules. And and even like you had big companies that got together and huge disagreements with it, they did it voluntarily because it's very costly to do business with violence, right? The insurance won't cover that. So it's like, well, we have this a lot of conflict and turmoil, let's just separate voluntarily and create our own into two different groups.
Yeah.
So they had different ways out because it was contractual, right? You have the freedom to cancel or unsubscribe.
Right.
So there's huge history in the back in the past where there was respect for these sort of things. There were experimental free market societies before the government encroached and finally took over the rest.
Right.
So yeah, there's a great book afterwards. I guess I'll give me your email address. I'll send it to you. It's called The Nacho Wild Wild West.
Yeah. But it seems like the problem then is that, you know, if you have this, you know, free market in place, there's always going to be someone who's the best at it. And then they're the ones who are going to monopolize.
Yeah, so maybe you'll find...
That's why the Wild West disappeared. It's because someone's like, you know, we're the government.
Oh, yeah, the government is not a free market society.
Right, I know. But I'm saying they came from one. Because I'm saying, I mean, the United States is a great example of a place that didn't used to really have a law in place because we discarded that, you know. We told, you know... England said, we don't ascribe to this anymore. And so we had that, you know? There was anarchy for a time, and then there was a free market in the Wild West.
Well, you have the encroachment. So, like, you had, like, even George Washington, 3% whiskey tax. Do you want to stand over here? Are you okay? You're like, Townsend, you're good? Okay. So you have, like, George Washington, like they got it right there in the very beginning, but they didn't go all the way to accept all taxation should be wrong, right? You have the whiskey tax, right? Yeah. It's like, well, like Jesus Christ, we went over at a war for like a tax on tea,
yeah.
Right? It's like, what are we doing the same thing again? Yeah. So they created excuses. So back then it'll be like 1% tax, over time 2-3, now it's nearly half your income. And over time that grows. So even back then when people think you can limit the size and scope of government or constrain and restrain it, it's never worked, right?
Yeah.
So we have to go start off from the very foundational basis, like with the values we already share, and then universalize that all the way, right? So regardless of what title then, or what color costume you wear, it's wrong and immoral for anyone to initiate for us.
Yeah.
And that includes, you know, government officials, right? That includes anyone, right? So back then they didn't do that.
Yeah.
Back then it wasn't contractual, right?
When
people say, well, there was a constitution, yeah, but they didn't have the consent by the women, by children, but people didn't have land, so you couldn't really say that was fully contractual as a society as a whole.
Yeah.
Right. So if we want to go to a better place, let's go in the better direction that's founded with these values that we already share in terms of contractual relationships, right? And turn away from that. This has done the opposite for like over 200 years, right?
Yeah.
And so that's what this table is about. I guess trying to get there as a community enrichment. You're a good man. Never having a conversation. Don't be rude, man. Do you want to be part of the conversation or not?
Oh.
Yeah, I'm recording this.
It's filming.
Yeah, it's filming. Yeah. Yeah, we'll talk in a second. So, yeah. But that's what all this is about.
Cool.
No, really good questions. But let me get your email address before
leave.
So I can send you that info.
Huh?